Before the vote, as we were leading to this important day, we have heard threats against the Palestinians, of various forms of retaliation from Israel, United States, some countries from the European Union. We think that it would be very wrong if this vote were to turn, or somebody were to try to turn it into further confrontation between the Israelis and the Palestinians. We think it's very important to make sure that it can be used as a stepping stone for restarting negotiations between the Israelis and the Palestinians. In fact, we voted for the resolution on the basis of assurances from the Palestinians that this is what they are going to try to do. We believe it would be wrong and a kind of a collective punishment against the Palestinians if all sorts of sanctions were imposed on them as a result of this vote. That could really exacerbate the situations between Israel and the Palestinians. It's clear that this resolution on its own is not sufficient in order to resolve the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Bilateral negotiations are necessary. It is important to satisfy, in the course of those negotiations, the concerns of the Israelis about their security. It's important to settle the border issue on the basis, we believe, of 1967 lines, and they were mentioned again in the resolution which was adopted today. So there is still a very long road ahead. Today is an important day. It's 65 years ago that the resolution was adopted by the General Assembly about dividing Palestine and creating two states. Only one of them has been created, Israel. Now we believe it's high time to move towards setting up the another state, the Palestinian state. And this opinion obviously is shared by those countries who voted for this resolution. The international community is fed up with the conflict. People in the United Nations, countries in the United Nations believe that dramatic steps need to be taken in order to have this conflict resolved.